Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner, available for code reviews and on-site training. In this episode, I am going to talk to you about the one C++ feature that I really think needs to go. It's taken me several years of teaching, training, speaking, code reviews, programming, to really realize how important it is that I think this particular feature really go. Now, of course, be sure as always to check out the description of this video for links to my projects, books, swag store, Patreon, ways that you can support this channel if you find this information interesting to you and valuable, and ways that you can, of course, bring me in for training at your company. I will say, honestly, I have been going out on a bit of a limb the last several episodes, talking more about the specific kinds of things that I would generally reserve for my training classes, but I think that it is very important for us to start really focusing on how to write safer C++. I think that this is becoming critical, more so than it ever was before. So for this particular episode, I'm going to just type out some examples and let you start to guess what issue it is I think should go. You do get a bit of a hint on the first example because of the warnings we are getting from the compiler here. Now the second one is a bit more insidious and definitely more dangerous. And we'll get to what exactly that's doing in a moment. You can see a few squiggles that hopefully are giving you some clues. Yeah, this third example is definitely directly related to the example that we saw a few weeks ago for that PlayStation jailbreak. This fourth example that I'm getting ready to type in has a very specific name, and perhaps you are familiar with it. And again, perhaps you're seeing some of the squiggles which clue you in. And now for the fifth and final example, this is one of those things that I just like to bring up when I'm doing training, and I've probably mentioned it in a few conference talks as well at this point. Now, on the chance you have not caught on yet, we're going to go ahead and walk through these blue squiggles. Now, I will say I was inspired enough during the planning of this episode that I actually went and created my own Clang Tidy checker that is not available publicly yet. You can find it on my fork of LLVM. It definitely needs some work. I don't know really how much more work it needs. I've been testing it against my own projects. So if you look here on the colon, and I definitely need to work on where exactly this is placed, you see this message that says, warning, implicit conversion from a pair of const basic string to a pair of string string. So there are specific test in our analyses today to look for this exact bug. But the error probably isn't clear here that there is a conversion happening from the map type, which is a const string, comma string, to a non-const string, comma string, and it binds to this temporary const reference here. So if I were to take off this ampersand, then we can see that only my error remains. Previous to this, we were getting analyses from Clang Tidy with existing checks and GCC's built-in checks because of this bind to temporary thing. But my warning here tells us that we are making a copy of data when we didn't necessarily plan to be making a copy. And if we come down here and look at this, so what we want to focus on here are the conversion warnings again. So I'm calling do work and I'm passing it a string. Now do work expects a string view. And most of you are going to say this is perfectly legitimate. Why should I care? But I have this implicit conversion from string to string view warning. And note that I say here potential for dangling reference detected. This is very much not a perfect description of the error here, but we're focusing on the fact that implicit conversion happened. And then inside the do work, I have the string view and I'm passing this to load file, which expects a file system path. And I have this warning implicit conversion from string view to file system path creates a new non-trivial object. And then I have a warning here that says implicit conversion from string to string view, potential for dangling reference again. So I am warning on all of these implicit conversions. And if we look here at get data size, then I have a warning implicit conversion from size t, aka unsigned long, to int affects readability. So this is again my implicit conversion warning. And then I have a warning here of int to size t, and I am the only one warning on that, and this is being passed to malloc. I do not have dash w conversion enabled with GCC, but it would warn on that if I had it enabled as well. This implicit conversion warning, along with the other warnings from our compiler and clang tidy, would have caught that PlayStation error in several different ways. Let's focus on this right here, where I'm the only one who can warn on this. I say implicit conversion from derived to base causes slicing and creates a new object. You might not have been expecting that if you had written this code. And then finally, again, a situation that only I warn on is the case where I have this vector of shared pointers and I am passing each element to a function expecting a shared pointer of const int versus a shared pointer of int. So I get a warning here again for my tool, implicit conversion from shared pointer of int to shared pointer of constant creates a new non-trivial object. So just in case you missed the point is I think implicit conversions need to go from the language. They offer far too many situations for real memory bugs, accidental copies, accidental slicing, overhead, memory leaks, dangling references. I think there's just far too many sharp edges on implicit conversions. And obviously there's some that we do want to keep. And if you dig into this, you'll see that there are a lot of implicit conversions that just simply make the language happen. I'm going to try to get rid of as many as I can, and I am working on a tool to that end, putting my time where my mouth is at the moment. So I don't know. Did I go too far? Maybe not. We'll see what happens next. I'm going to keep working on this, but be sure to leave a comment as always. Be sure to check out the links in the video description, subscribe, and thank you for watching this episode of C++ Weekly.